What's up, everybody? This is Nick with Tom Shaver's RV, and today we're going to show you the 2023 Forest River Sunseeker 2440DS. This is on their Ford engine 7.3 liter V8. We're going to show you the inside here. I'm going to show you with the unit closed up so you can see your walking space that you have in this whole unit. We can show you that you can go all the way to the back of this bathroom without even taking the slides out. So that's one big advantage that this camper has. You can get back from sitting back to your bathroom if you're along the road. So let's go check this unit out and show you what it has to offer. Let's go. All right, so since the slides are closed, we're gonna take the opportunity to show you the room you have to move inside your coach without the slides being out. So as you can see, I can get past here to the actual oven if I need to make anything quick, to the microwave that's down below here. I can get to the refrigerator. So if I need food while on the road, guess what? Boom, it's right here. It's 12 volt. This thing's already kicking. It's already cold. It's already ready to go when you're on the road. Hey, you got nice cold drinks along the way, or sandwiches as well to make. As you can continue, I can get to my wardrobe area here, which I'll show you more in depth in a little bit. And then the biggest thing is I can get to this bathroom. So this bathroom fully in the back here, it actually wraps around, the toilet's on the other side, but with the slides being out, I still have the ability to walk all the way through this coach. It's only a 27 foot coach, so it's not too big. It's still gonna be under your 30 foot range, which a lot of people are looking for, but it's a great start if you're looking for just a couple's coach. This is gonna be definitely the one for you. Let's check out more. Alrighty, so what I didn't show you is over the cab. So this is your over the cab spot. If you have some people that need to sleep or you need a little bit extra sleeping room, you have space for like one or two up here, honestly. You do have about only a 440 pound load up front, so good enough for maybe two young adults to sleep up here at night. You're also getting a big screen TV that you can stow away while traveling, so it's not going to bounce up and down for you. So at least you have a nice screen that's going to pop out. Nice area, so it goes basically looking at your right on your theater seat, or you can watch from your bed. Staying up front here, in the middle, you have space for your drinks to put while you're traveling. It's actually really nice, and you can actually remove this if you want to, if you want a little bit more space to swing when you're trying to go back to the bathroom if you're swinging from the road. You are going to have a little screen here. So this is gonna have Sirius, Bluetooth, your phone, your rear camera if it wants to, or something with the USB if you wanna play anything through the USB. But what's nice is you have your backup camera here. This is gonna show you your backup, and then you do have left and right cameras. On a 30 foot or less unit, it's really unique to have left and right turn signal cameras on the side. Something this short normally doesn't get it, but at the same time, they are starting to put more and more cameras on the sides of these units, so it's really nice. It's just a little bit more ease of mind when you're going to pass or you're turning a lane just to see what's to the left of you, because it does get tight sometimes in a Class C, that's for sure. You do have your driver's seat here. Zoom out for you. And then your passenger seat is over here. They picked a really nice gray tone up front here, and it works throughout the whole coach, which is really nice. No. Only 640 miles. That's typical when they come from the factory. That's about the mileage they get to come here to Shoemakersville, Pennsylvania. And your basic warm, cold, low, high, your ventilation, nothing really too high-techy up here. You still have a touchscreen area for everything else. Everything else is going to be turned up knobs for you, which is nice. Let's continue to the back. Now, since we just pulled out both slides, this is what the interior looks like with both of those slides open and your bedroom pulled out. So this is, if you've seen the little hyperlink before this, so this bed is gonna basically fold up and down. So this is a half, so that's gonna pull in when the slide comes in. And then when you're done pulling the slide out, this is just gonna slide forward and go straight in the back for you. So now this is the room you get with the slide out on this unit. See the bedroom out, it's gonna be a half bed that you just kinda have to push into the slide when the bedroom slide is fully out. These are your theater seats, like I was talking about. I said you have the push pins here for basically like a theater dinette table that pops out for you, so you at least can eat at the theater seats too. It does have USB outlets here too. That's always a plus. You can charge your phone. You do have some storage space above this. That's all throughout the whole cabinetry there. So throughout this whole slide, you do get slides, and storage, and this is the dinner plate. So dinner plate is gonna go in here, and you have a little table to put your food on and just relax and eat too. If you don't have room outside or it's a rainy day like this, you're at least gonna eat inside. Let's put that back up here. And then going to kitchen area. So you are going to get a really nice deep sink here. Really, really nice deep sink. You also do get the adjustable nozzle to pull out and also do your dishes. This is gonna be your trash bin. So at least it gives you a hole, open it up. You kind of keep it covered up if you need that extra storage space or counter space on your table here. And also they do have a wireless phone charging here too. A lot of the new Class C and Class A's are putting those wireless chargers in. Just a lot of the phones are dropping charge now, so they're just upgrading to those in the camper now. Above everything, little storage spot here. You do get above too if you want to plug anything in, like a DVD player or anything, and send it to the TV here up front. And then you have all your mechanicals here, your Jennies here. You do have your water heater, which is electric and gas, water pump, Arctic pack. So the Arctic pack on these gonna have 12 volt pads on these tanks. It's just gonna keep it a little bit warm when it gets kind of in the colder temperatures. And then you do have your driver's side rear lights here, and then your slide out for your theater seats is on this too. And then all your gray, black, fresh battery LP, how that's all doing, all your buttons are here. Continuing up here, and you got your storage up top here, storage up top here too. And for the appliances on this, you get your three burner stove, and then you are going to get your microwave down below. You're not gonna get your oven in this, just the room that they have to play with, so you still get a little bit of storage up top. They're gonna give you the microwave instead. And you still get storage below. And then this is under the sink storage, and then you do have three pull-out storage points in this unit. There's all three for you. It's really nice about Forest River too, what they're doing in the Sunseekers. They're making a one-piece laminate, which is really nice, which means your heating core is gonna be in the sides of your coaches. So there's one up front here, below the kitchen. And then moving along, you do get your 110 outlets over here. They give you a little storage area. You wanna put books, magazines. You get a tall storage inside the slide, and then you're gonna pull this out. So that is going to be a little spice rack or anything that you want it to be. It's gonna be a little bit more storage for you. And then the only thing that's gonna separate the living room to the bedroom, it's gonna be this little snap pad. And then this is gonna go all the way around the unit. So you have a little track that's above there. And this is just going to expand all the way across. I'm only doing this with one hand, and it's pretty hard, but that's gonna go all the way across. Can't do it with one hand. It's like an accordion style shade for you then. And then that's just gonna snap back on for you there. Moving to the left, the refrigerator, of course, 12 volt refrigerator, like I was saying earlier. So full 12 volt refrigerator. Like I said, it's on right now. It really doesn't take a lot of electric, and it doesn't really draw a lot of power. Just because it's 12 volt, it's gonna take a little bit less to keep cold, which is really nice while traveling or trying to do some boondocking. To the right here, it's gonna be your closet. So nice big closet storage space in here. Basically, you get the whole door in here, which is really nice. And hanger to hang some shirts and everything too, so that's a plus. They also give you ability to fold some clothes over here, whatever you need to do on the door side. At least they give you ideas. And then you do have your separate slide button back here for the bedroom. And then also your GE, all your controls back here. Your lights, your 110 outlets, and then like I said, you still get a TV back here in the bedroom. And then the bedroom slide, you get two overhead storage points there. There are two little clickable lights, like reading lights above. And then anything like this bedding, how it's kind of split in half, because this obviously has the slide in with the slide. You can get a mattress topper. People like to get a mattress topper for these because you get a full queen. It's going to be hard to like kind of tilt that bed up and keep it inside. And then you're just taking up more walkable room while you're driving. So a lot of people get a mattress topper. Let's continue in the bathroom.
My head is almost hitting this sunlight in here, sunroof. So, and my shoulders, I am squeezing from shoulder to shoulder in here, and I'm touching both sides of the shower. If I turn to the sideways, it's got a little bit more room, but this is definitely gonna be a full wash and go. This is not gonna be an enjoyable shower, but at least still gives me an option to get clean while out on the road or boondocking for a quick camper shower. Not big man approved for sure, but at least it's a quick wash, at least stay clean, but it's not gonna be a big show for you, so not big man approved. All right, so there is the shower I was just in. Showed you, it's a little bit tight, but to be expected on a little 27-foot Class C. Not gonna give you the biggest shower, but if you're tinier than me, shorter, it's definitely gonna work for you for sure. And then they do give you some medicine cabinet space in here. You're still getting a little sink. You gotta watch out, everything is winterized right now. And then you're still getting some storage space below. You're still getting your 110 outlet there.
All right, and then moving on to basically where the toilet is. If you come in, you're basically going to a separate room, and the toilet is back on your left on the Sunseeker. But right here is gonna be your wardrobe. So you get a long closet to begin with on the right side here. And then you're gonna be getting a little bit of a deeper closet for clothing in here. Not the biggest, but at least it's something. It's definitely unique. I've never seen a bathroom like this yet. And you're getting three big, or actually four, big pull-out drawers here. That's definitely enough space for bathroom, toiletries, whatever you may need. They're still giving you a nice wardrobe here in the bathroom area, and basically like a separate toilet area too. Never seen it before, very unique. Let me know what you guys think in the comments of how you like this bathroom layout. All right, so that's gonna do it for the inside of this 2023 Forest River Sunseeker 2440DS. We showed you everything that this has to offer on the inside. So now I'm gonna close these slides back up in case of snow. We don't like to put the snow on top of our slide topper, so we just like to keep them in. So I'm gonna close this unit up, and then we're gonna do a little walk around on the outside, show you the outside storage. I'll see you then. All right, like I said, this Sunseeker is on your Ford E450. So this is gonna be your 7.3 liter V8. So starting on the outside here, you're gonna have a little bit of storage on the campsite here. You do have some 12 volt outlets here, your cable, and you get a 110 as well. Hot water heater, your propane's on this side too. Your Suburban water heater is here. And then you do have storage here for you. So this is on the back of the unit, and you do get storage on the other back side here, and that's kind of like a see-through. So that is your see-through storage. Then working on the non-camp side of this unit, so this is going to be up front is going to be your Onan 4000 generator, and then you are getting some storage doors here. So storage there underneath, there's your underneath storage right there. You do get your cable hookup here and your 30 amp unit here. This is your gas fill, and then your fresh water fill is going to be up here for you for the bathroom. And this is going to be your sewer outlet area. So your sewage hose is right back there with your outdoor shower area, and that is your black tank flush as well, and your city water connection is in there. And then once again, this is to the back side of the back of that storage see-through, pass-through storage. And then of course, making our way to the back of this unit, your backup camera is above there. You're still gonna have a hitch down below here with your seven-way pin. So it's gonna be about a 7,500 pound pin limit for you there on the hitch. All right, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed the walkthrough of the 2023 Forest River Sunseeker 2440DS. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Hope you guys hit that like and subscribe button. I'm still getting used to saying that on YouTube. Make sure you guys hit that button. If you have any feedback, let us know. Any questions, leave us a comment, and we're happy to get back to you and talk to you about what you like and don't like on this unit. Have a good day, guys.